My name is Ketema Paul. We're at Morehouse School of Medicine in Atlanta, Georgia, and I am a neurobiologist.
All right, fellas, what do we have here?
We're really interested in the neural underpinnings of sleep processes and how impairments in those underpinnings can lead to sleep disorders. I'm from Washington, D.C. I got drawn to science early on when I was a very little kid. I do remember my cousin in the island of Trinidad had a chemistry set when I was about 6 or 7. That's the first time I can remember saying, this is really cool. I grew up in an urban neighborhood which became very dangerous and violent in my teenage years. Drugs kind of took over the neighborhood. I lost a lot of my friends to violence. And even when I was in high school and having to avoid a lot of the dangers that growing up in that neighborhood presents, I still always kind of maintain my focus on becoming a scientist. There's very little that speaks to the soul than your first scientific discovery. It's like you know something important and you're the only person in the world that knows it. Now, obviously, your job is to communicate that. But I knew that I wanted to do biomedical research. I knew I wanted to do something that was more directly practical to helping people every day. My mission here at Morehouse School of Medicine is to improve sleep outcomes for the general public. If you aren't sleeping properly, it dramatically increases your risk for disease and for death. So there are two types of sleep disorders. They are those that are caused by disease processes in the body, like narcolepsy and several forms of apnea. And there are those that are caused by environmental considerations. And those are the ones that are more prevalent. We have an epidemiology project where we're looking at sleep disorders in people who work night and rotating shifts. The best types of experiments to design are experiments that have two outcomes, and either outcome answers your question conclusively. Now, there's always a third outcome, which is the experiment didn't work. And so we did not get it conclusive. But the better designed your experiment, the better the controls, the less likely that outcome. If in our epidemiological study, we find out that not only are rotating and night shift workers more likely to be more sleepy, but if we also discover that that's associated with a risk for metabolic disorders or cardiovascular disorders, then that is an awesome day. And we generally go out and do tequila shots after that. I tend to run a relatively looser lab. I think it's just a relic of the way I was trained. We're productive, but we tend to be pretty laid back.
Yes.
And we all collaborate heavily.
This paper has to get into a high impact journal. I'm hoping if they ask us to do more experiments, we will already have done them.
We have to continue to challenge each other. I've had a lot of jobs before I went to graduate school. This is the only job I've ever had that you can do something different every single day if you so chose. If you have an active mind and like to do new things, it is, I think, the career for you. If you think that a job that might have you in the lab 1 week and have you flying out to Costa Rica the next week, or may have you taking blood 1 week, or going to a health fair in a rural part of Georgia trying to convince people to seek therapy another week, it really stretches you and allows you to take advantage of your broad interests.